Hello everyone, are you ready to progress with this let's play? We're going here to the Robot Academy. I just realized I think I recognized this from episode 2. Anyway. Yeah, here's the thing. Okay. Oh, look at that controller. Go and do this. We'll be revisiting this in episode 2 as well, by the way. I don't think we will in episode 3. Sounds like more kind of game right there. We'll be going there soon, but I have to know that it is this one. Interesting. Does secrecy legislation work in the world of some of all if they can put this in the quiz machine? Just the same. Okay. Yeah, I just beat them up. You just suck. Or he didn't have the walkthrough available to him. Thank you, Split Infinity. The simple truth, Mr. Matt, is that you are simply a very questionable individual. I can get that this is probably meant to be fun, funny. But I'm not laughing at all. The professor and the Robot Academy side stories in Xenosaga is okay. Well, I'll say it is the second worst part of the series for me. The only thing I like less in Xenosaga than these bits is the Global Samaritan side quests in episode 2. Yeah, I even like the combat system in episode 2 better than this. Still, well, we do this for the Editor Kaiser. We have some cheese strats to perfect, yeah? So, we leave and come back since we have found an arm or two. I hope. We could start by throwing him out, actually. Speaking of which, I just watched a long play of Jeff, and man, that game did a mostly indestructible game before actually it's I played the game. I did when it was relatively new. Super fun game. If you look at it, if you don't look at that, it's not still effective. Something that looks like it came out of Kingdom Hearts. I wish we'd be saying that Kingdom Hearts was not out when this game was being made. Uh, but that object is actually going to be featured in the animation that we get if we use this ether that we now have. Let me show you that real quick. Set only blade. Giant top attack. Yep. If we use it, that thing will just whoosh in, spin around a little bit, and do very little damage. And then we get the Articaster and we drop. But that is a matter for another day. Now we get to explore the city. Actually, can we see you for some parts? I'm going to check the emails here. Nope. We are not going to be getting any investment emails for quite a while, so we are free to spend our money any way you like. That seems real good. Yep. Ah, the Gatling guns. I have fond memories of those. At least the bigger kind. One of these, I think. Yes, do you have this one of all these? We do. Great. That is great. We are seeing pretty. We're just gonna see. I wonder for time. Okay, yeah. So, downtown Kukai, here we go. Yeah, by the way, those who are new to this game, you should keep this in mind, how this bit looks for a little later in the game. It won't be too far away. The Iron 3. Anyway, I think this guy is used for something as well. Well, we'll be doing a lot more here in episode 2. Okay, well that explains the silent ambient sounds. Yeah. She's going to be losing her ring again in episode 2. Thankfully, and not in episode 3. So, hint, hint, hint. Do you remember the nice lady who said something about the fish detector? Well, anyway, that is all we needed to do in here right now, so we move on. Yeah, if you enter this place, by the way, you should be aware that there is a save point in here. I'll just go in and use it real quick. But if you talk to the receptionist here, you're going to cause the story to advance. You do not want this. You have some more side quests to deal with, and I don't know if we will be able to easily get back to them if we trigger story progression here. Well, if you say so. Hello to you. Okay. Yeah, I don't really like these characters either, to be perfectly honest. But I do like them more than I like the dear professor. Because King likes cats. I like cats too. I think you're the most poorly animated character in this game, but I digress. Sound interesting. Be very careful when you destroy this one, because you need to not destroy this one for an email. Now, I don't remember if I spoke to him on camera, but I know I've spoken to him before in past playthroughs. Yeah, sure, let's go through them all. I think we got that, actually. Yeah, like a couple of 100,000 money. We've discovered that already. We know that as well. That is useful information, though. I don't remember if we've picked up that signal address yet. Okay. You notice that we can destroy that thing. If we don't, we will get an email, if we do destroy that thing, we will not get that email. We need to go through here first. Ah, well, okay, I guess we could get there through the outside as well, but the walkthrough takes us this way. Who am I to argue? Right, they have gas stoves. I haven't seen those since I... Hello. I don't have a key. Roger that. Okay, if you say so. It's not up to me to set you straight. So yeah. If you remember before at the quiz machine they spoke about things that was hanging in the laundromat, it's this lineup we're looking at here. And the second one from the left is a purple t-shirt. Now, the costume over on the right, that is right above Xion right now, I would like to think that it is Kairush 3-Pood's costume from Monkey Island 2. LeChuck's Revenge, that is. But it probably is not. And now we have the beam card B for whatever reason. How we are supposed to know that it is here, I have no idea. And now, we were told about this over on the dock colony. Now we have the fish detector, so now we can go and find that ring for that scatterbrained woman. Save a marriage, kind of thing. I think we can exit here, right? Oh, yeah. Okay, I entered the house a bit too soon. Yeah, learn by watching your boss do things. The Xenosaga way. the episode is getting a bit long, but we're not far from a chapter transition, so I think I'll keep it all in one episode. Smile Bakery. We need to go this way for this email that we get right now. Now, do we see someone on the upper left side of the picture? Thing. Okay, let's see. To the beach we go again. Apparently, we're looking for the big fish. That looks like a small fish. Also a small fish. Oh, you're kind of a big fish. Yeah, there you go. I got the ring. Yeah. We could get the speed stim and the med kit if we stay here and catch more fish, but we don't need those. Okay, so let's just hand over that ring. I did. Decode rate. Sure. Not quite sure where that is, of course. Now we can go and get some rest. And bada boom. Okay, So it is back to Elsa on the Durandal. Episode, and we're just wrapping things up here in this one. So we need to link there. That is our decoder one. So yeah. I will now go back to the Elsa, save the game there, and oh, that's not where I need to go. I will also take the time to check if I have all the cartridges for Elsa shock blade. That's the one. Right. I'll see you in the next episode. We will return again when we are at the Elsa.